Hey guys, Almost Addicted here, and today we are building this small survival starter house. And as you can see, I made sure the design was perfect and it uses hardly any resources. It's got everything you need to survive for your very first night. Now, I've also shown you different ways that you could maybe expand on it as well. So as you can see, we've got a little underground base area where you can obviously expand this as far as you like, but we've got an enchantment table. Maybe you could do an underground nether there as well. Now make sure you slap a big like on this video, it really does help me out. And so without further ado, let's build this awesome house. Right, so this will fit in an 11 by 13 little box area, and I've actually put all the resources you will need in this chest, so if you want to pause the video and collect all that stuff. Now, there might be a bit over on some of them, but it's just to make sure we've got enough resources. So I'm going to start off with the cobblestone, of course, and then with our next layer will be the spruce. Now, I forgot the door, so make sure you get yourself a door. Now, you could get an oak door or something like that. That would be perfect. Now, for the roof, we're going to be using a lot of slabs. Now, I got the oak panels here. Now, I forgot to take the slabs. So, slab-wise, I would probably go into here, get some oak slabs, maybe grab a stack. I think that should be more than enough. And also, side note, get some dirt as well. So, dirt-wise, it's going to be easy to collect. I'm only going to be getting, it's going to be 4 times 2, 8. 8 blocks. So yeah, we're going to start off with the cobblestone. It's going to be super simple, super easy and slow. So we're going to put a cobblestone here, and then we're going to put an oak into the ground. Now we're going to dig out this space. So we're going to dig out 1, 2, 3, and then place 3 oak. Dig out another 3, place 1, 2, 3 oak. Dig out another 3. And then 2 to the side of it, and then place 2 oak. And then the next step, you're going to be digging out 6 here and fill it in like this. Now we can start on the walls. So we're going to go diagonal here like this and go diagonal here like this. So we should have that sort of shape so far. Now expand into this on this side. We're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4. So altogether on this line, there will be 5. And then next we're going to go diagonal out, and then 1, 2, 3, diagonal in towards here. And then for this little bit, as you can see here, we're just going to count 1, 2, 3 at the side of there, 1, 2, 3, and then 1 to close it. Now what you can do here, just as a little thing, you can put the cobblestone into the ground, then you can grab some of the cobblestone stairs and then put the stair there if you would like. Now I'll just show you. It just kind of makes that little groove underneath like it's got an underground basement. So if you want to add a little extra detail, you can do that. So this is the front face of the building. Now I put the door on from the inside so we can place the door on ready. Now what we're going to do is place 2 of the spruce here and then 3 across the top like that. So for this bit here, we're going to count up 1, 2, 1, 2 at this side and all the way across like that. And then for the windows, what I did, I grabbed some of the trapdoors, so you can grab your trapdoors now. And I put them in from the inside, so like that, so they open up outwards. I left one open like that, as you can see over there. Now here, what I did is I grabbed the dirt, so obviously your ground would still be filled in. And I counted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 across there, another 5. And then I got trapdoors and I wrapped it round it. So I got the trapdoors going round here. Like this, filling round so we can fill our farm in. I did actually remove this one block, and this is for our farm, so obviously we're going to put our water source in here. If you want an infinite water source, where you can keep collecting, just do 3 like this. And yeah, I'm going to actually cover this water up before it drowns everything. What is going on? Is this new water mechanics or something? Right, so like that, if you put a bucket here, and a bucket here, you can take from the middle and you can always get refills of your water. But if not, you can just have it for your farm like that. We'll work on the farm a little bit later, but we'll go on to our next step. So at the back here, we're going to count 1, 2, 1, 2, and then like that, we can obviously put our window in from this side and just place it up. So our next stage, we're going to go like this, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Just fill all these up, and this one as well. Now at the back here, I think I did put a little window there, so you can have a little window at this side piece. So that's the front, and the left hand side we're gonna have a little window. So obviously if we go in from the inside, place that trap door and then close it. So now we're on to, maybe we should start the roof. So we're gonna count 1, 2 here, 1, 2 here, and then we're gonna place one and then one on top of it, one on top of it, and then place one at the top, one on top of it like this, just like that. So at the side here we're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we're going to do exactly the same at the back. So 1, 2, 1, 2 either side of these three, and then one stack on top of it, one stack on top of it, one at the top like that. Now at the side here, I think I did go all the way around. Yeah, I did. So we're going to count 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and close that gap together. Now at the top here, what you can do is fill one spruce like that, and then we can get our trap door. So I'll just get my trap door from here and just place it on top. Now for this bit here, we can grab our normal wood planks and count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, closing it from the middle, and then we go onto our slabs again. So we fill in this side, we go to this side and fill it in like that. Perfect. And then we can leave that little bit. Now if you want a little chimney, you can take out a little area here or something like that, and we're going to place one cobblestone, two cobblestone. In fact, I just do one, because on the inside I think I do actually put a furnace on there. So we'll go like that, and then what we're going to do is we're going to grab one of these cobblestone walls and we're going to place it on top for our little chimney. Now as you can see, the roof here, exactly the same as there, perfect. And it's becoming nighttime, so I'm just gonna change it to daytime. Okay, we are onto our next step. Now at the side here, I placed two bushes and then another two there like that. And then I got one wooden fence and a stone pressure plate going on top. It just makes kind of like a little table. And at the side here, I just placed one flower pot and then I just put a little flower in. Now at the back of the building here, so I went all the way around to the back, I wanted to have like a little ledge, so I place one stair like that, and then if you place a stair like that, it just kind of curls round and it's got like a little side shelf. So we put a plant pot on and maybe another flower like that, and I think we are pretty much done outside. All we need to do now is obviously get our farm all done, and we can place our seeds in. Now you can place whatever you like. I'm just putting wheat. And then obviously you can wait for it to grow. I'm gonna put a bit of bone meal around the area like that, and there you go, we have got a farm and we can now start to work on the inside. So yep. Okay, so let's work on the inside. So on the inside, what I did is I put a furnace here and then a crafting table, and what I actually did is grab some of the cobblestone and just place a cobblestone there, and then I got this furnace just covering up that bit with an oak fence, or two oak fences joining up like that. I just put a little jukebox at the side. Obviously all of these are optional. I put three chests up. Now you can remove that. In some versions it actually opens up so you can actually get into the roof. It goes through half slabs for some reason. In some versions it does and some versions it doesn't. And obviously we're going to put our bed down, and then if you would like, you can put like a little carpet down. You can obviously add little bits of torches around the area just to light it up, and on the outside as well. As you can see, we've got a little light coming through here, there. And now I dug all the way down here, so you can dig down. I dug down 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. Obviously we can fill that in, but obviously I can't do all that because of the version I'm on. And then what you can do is obviously put the ladder going down like this, and then we can put our trapdoor on top, and there we are finished. But obviously if you're wanting to do the underground base and you are wanting this little area here, so you dig down that much and then you've got this. I will show you how to build this. Obviously we're going to need some bookshelves. You're going to need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 bookshelves. And then what I did do is I actually grabbed a glowstone, but you can obviously use a torch as well. I'm going to show you up on the surface how you would get your level 30 enchantment if you don't know how to do it. So it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And what I did is I put a glowstone underneath, And then I got my enchantment table, and obviously you can dig round like this and then put your floor on like this, not the floor in that, and we're gonna put it in the oak. So put the oak round like this, matching the flooring that we've got upstairs, and of course we put this area around like this, imagining this is the top level, like that. So obviously you'd need a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 area. So a 7 by 6 area digging down, and you need to dig down like 3, 1, 2, 3, like that. So you dig a hole that's like that going down, and 7 by 6, and then you can obviously make your underground base. But what you can do is you can put the nether down there, you can do an underground base. I've actually done a few underground base tutorials. I will put one of them in the description maybe, and I shall check you in the next video. Make sure you slap a huge like on the video if you enjoyed this. I've got some more houses coming very, very soon, some more survival starter houses, but let me know what you think. I just think it's a really cute, easy, super easy survival house for maybe your first night, or maybe your first couple of nights even. But yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed, and I shall see you in the next video. Almost Addicted, signing out. Peace.